Yes, very good evening, children. So today I'm going to explain about lab activity Ohm's law. It's a very most important, children. Be concentrated. The topic is Ohm's law. So by this activity, what we conclude that means we have to show that V by I value is constant of the conductors. V by I value is constant for the conductors. So now aim of this activity to show that V by I is constant for conductors. V by I is constant for conductor. So here conductor means the material which allow the electricity through itself is called conductors. We know that all the examples were all the metal. Examples for conductors, all the metal. So metals are good conductors, we know that here. We have to show the V by I value is constant for conductors. Voltage and current. We have to show that V by I value is constant for the conductors. So for this activity, material required. What material required for this? Let me see the material required is 1 ammeter, voltmeter, conducting wires, dry cells, pipe, which are 1.5 volts. And iron spoke, switch, and the battery. So these are the required material, children. Ammeter, voltmeter, conducting wires, dry cells pipe, iron spoke, switch, battery, and LED. So these are the required material. These are very, very, very most important, children. Very, very important this lab activity. So required material, ammeter is required, voltmeter is required, conducting wires are required, and dry cells foil, iron spoke, switch, battery, and LED. So first of all, we have to construct the circuit for this. We have to construct the circuit. Let us draw a circuit. It is ammeter, children. So ammeter is used to measure the current. Ammeter is used to measure the current. This is used to measure the current. And next one is switch. Conducting wires. And it is a iron spoke. It is a voltmeter used to measure the voltage. Voltmeter is used to measure the voltage. So these are the conducting wires. Conducting wires and iron spoke it is. Battery. It is ammeter. It is voltmeter. Okay, children. So this is the circuit. Okay. Now, according to this, what we have to show here? We have to show the V by I value is constant for conductors. So here we have to connect the one conductor. Iron spoke is connect in between the two terminals here. Iron spoke is a good conductor. Okay, children. First, we have to connect the iron spoke. Okay. Now procedure. First, we have to add here five dry cells are there here. One by one, we have to add the cell to the circuit and observe the current and voltage. The how much current flows through that and how much voltage flows through that. We have to take the readings, voltage and the current. Let us see one by one, children. Just you add one dry cell to the circuit. When switch is closed now, switch closed means electricity passes through the circuit. When the switch is closed, then the current passes through this circuit. And observe that here, how much current is flows through this by using the ammeter. Note the value of current here. By using the ammeter, the how much current is flows through this circuit because of we add one dry cell to this. The first cell we have to add to this. Yes, switch is closed now and take the reading of current by the help of ammeter. How much current is flows through the circuit? Then take the reading of current. For example, current is I. It is for example, I is 2 amperes. 2 amperes. And at the same time, check the voltage. How much voltage is used to the iron spoke? And take the voltage reading also, children. We add one cell to the battery and we have to take the reading of ammeter. It is measure the current. That we have to take the current reading. At the same time, the how much voltage is required for this? Take the voltage reading also. Then it is the V. For example, V means here 10 volts, for example. Okay, children. And next, add one more dry cell. Name the second cell. Add the second dry cell. Say the switch is closed now and observe the current, how much flows through this. Take the current reading and voltage reading also, how much voltage is used in this. Then same way, take the current value, I equals to, for example, 3 amperes and voltage V is, for example, 15 volts. Same way, add one more dry cell. Switch is closed to this. Now take the reading of current by the help of ammeter. So how much current is flows through this? For example, current value is 4 amperes and voltage is 20 volts. Current value take by the help of ammeter and voltage value now take the help of voltmeter. Voltmeter is shows the reading of voltage and current reading is shows in ammeter. Okay, children. And do the process same up to using up five dry cells. Repeat this process same up to the five cells. And finally, we have to check the V by I value. We have to find the V by I value here. What we have to find? V by I value. Let me find the V by I value. So first one is V. V means how much number? V means 10. Okay. First, V means 10. V by I value. You have to take the V by I. The first one, V means 10 by I means 2. 2 ones are 2 fives are. It is 5. Next, second one. First, V voltage, V means 15. Current is 3 amperes. 3 ones are 3 fives are. It is also 5. Second one, V by I, V means 20, I means 4, 4 ones are 4 fives are, equals to 5. Then here, V by I value, the V by I value is constant. Check this, we have to take the 3 readings here. V by I, the first instant, 5, second, 5, third observation, 5. Then V by I value is constant. So what are the values are came out here? This V by I is nothing but resistance. V by I equals to R. V by I equals to R. So R means resistance. V by I equals to R. So these values are R values, resistance values. Resistance means the obstruction of flow of electrons in the conductor. Means the electrons is flows very slowly. The resistance will be obstruct the flow of current. So the obstruction of flow of current in a conductor is called resistance. The value which is comes out, this is the resistance value. It is denoted by R. The obstruction of flow of electrons in a conductor is called resistance. So resistance is measured in, resistance is denoted by R. It is measured in ohms units, because it was proposed by George Simon Ohm. Ohm's law was proposed by George Simon Ohm. George Simon Ohm. So that's why the units of resistance is ohms. Symbol it is ohm symbol, children, please. It is the ohm symbol. Now it is a 5 ohms. Now here V by I value is constant for metal, because of we have to use the metal here. Okay, sir, we are using the metal here. We are using the metal. Iron spoke. Iron is the good conductor. So that's why what the aim here to show that V by I is constant for conductor. So here iron is a good conductor. When we use the iron spoke and when we add one battery to this, and when we take the observations of current and voltage, their values are constant. V by I values are constant. Then the V by I equals to what R. R means resistance. Resistance means the obstruction of flow of electrons in a conductor. Resistance is obstruct the electrons. It will stop the electrons in the conductor. Okay. So resistance is denoted by R. That means V by I equals to R. These all the values are belongs to R values. Resistance is measured in ohms units. Symbol of ohm it is. Okay. Once you check that, children, all the V by I values are constant. 5, 5, 5. So if you want to show this with the graph, the relation between current and voltage for the conductor V and I. So here all the values are constant. That's why V by I values are, they are straight in line. The graph is straight line graph. So that's why here V by I is constant for metal. We have to use the iron spoke here. Iron spoke is a metal. That's why V by I values all are constant. Okay. And we have to show this with the graph, the relation between V and I. That is straight in line for the conductors. Okay. Now, the same process. Instead of these, take the LED. Now take the LED. Instead of iron spoke, take the LED. Connect the LED to the terminals of battery. Now it is LED, children. Repeat the activity same. The first add one dry cell. Close the switch. And take the reading of ammeter and voltmeter. For example, current is say 2 amperes, voltage is, for example, 10 amperes, 10 volts. Add one more cell, switch close, take the reading of current and voltage by the help of ammeter and voltmeter. Current is, for example, 3 amperes and voltage is 14 volts. Now say, repeat the torque, add the torque cell. Switch is closed now. And take the reading of current and voltage. For example, current is 4 amperes and voltage is, for example, here 18 volts. Same, find the V by I value for each case. V by I equals what of R. Find the V by I value for the LED. So first V means 10 by I means 2. 2 ones are 2 5s are. The first instant is 5 ohms. And the second one, voltage is 14 volts, 4 amperes current, 4 ones are, 4 threes are, 2 remains, 0.6. It is 3.6 ohms. Now third instant here 18 ohms by current, how much of a 4 amperes, 4 4 is 16, 2 remains 4.5, means 4.5 ohms. Once observe children, V by I values are for the LEDs. So here V by I value, first instant 5 ohms, second instant here 3.6 ohms, third instance here 4.5 ohms. Now when we connect the LED to the circuit, the V by I values are varies from every situation. It is varied from every situation. Due to this, what we conclude that here, Ohm's law is not constant for semi-metal and non-metal. Here the V by I value, according to the V by I value, try to show the graph. The graph will be curved because it is not a constant. V by I values are, it is not a constant. That's why the V by I value in the graph shows the curve. Because of it is not a constant for LED. Okay, children. So this is according to this activity, what we conclude that here, the V by I values are constant for conductors. Conductors is nothing but metals. But the V by I values are not constant for semi-metal and non-metal. So here LED is the semi-metal, so that it is. Semiconductor it is. So the semiconductor, see this, it is not a constant for this. Okay, so this is the Ohm's law. But what is the Ohm's law definition here? When temperature is constant, voltage is directly proportional to the current. It is called Ohm's law. When temperature is constant, voltage is directly proportional to the current. That means voltage increase means current also increase. It is called directly proportional. When temperature is constant, voltage is directly proportional to the current. It is called Ohm's law. Ohm's law. Okay, children, are understood now? So this Ohm's law valid for, it is valid for metals. This law is not valid for semi-metals and non-metal. So it is the limitation of Ohm's law. Limitation of Ohm's law. Limitation of Ohm's law. What is the limitation? That means it is valid for metals only. This law is valid for metals only. It is not valid for semi-metals and non-metal. This is the limitation of Ohm's law. Okay, children? What is Ohm's law? When temperature is constant, voltage is directly proportional to the current. This is called Ohm's law. Okay, children, limitation of Ohm's law. What is limitation of Ohm's law? It is limit to the metals only. This is valid for metals only. Means the Ohm's law is valid for metals only. It is not valid for semi-metal and non-metal. It is limitations of Ohm's law. So this is the concept of the Children Ohm's law concept, lab activity, very most important detail. Now one more important ohmic conductors and non ohmic conductors. What are the differences between these two, ohmic conductors and non ohmic conductors? What are the difference between ohmic conductors and non ohmic conductors? Okay children, let us see the difference in between them. It is ohmic it is non ohmic conductors. Let us see the difference. The first one, ohmic conductors, first point. Ohmic conductor means the conductors which obey the Ohm's law, means which accept the Ohm's law, they are called ohmic conductors. Okay children, which are obey the Ohm's law, the conductors which are obey the Ohm's law, they are called ohmic conductors. Means here, which are accepted the Ohm's law, that is called ohmic conductors. The conductors which are obey the Ohm's law, they are called ohmic conductors. Which are obey the Ohm's law, they are called ohmic conductors. Opposite to this, the conductor which does not obey the Ohm's law, the conductor which does not obey the Ohm's law, they are called non-ohmic conductor children. Means they are not accepted Ohm's law. What is Ohm's law? When temperature is constant, voltage is directly proportional to the current. This is the Ohm's law. Which are accepted this law, they are called ohmic conductor. Which are does not accept this law, they are called non-ohmic conductors. And the second point in this example, all the metals are accepted Ohm's law. Here, non-metals and the semi-metals. Non-metals and the semi-metals. Third point in this, V by I is constant. Here, third point, V by I is not constant. Because only the metal V by I values are constant. When we are connect the semi-metal, the values are different from one to another. That's why V by I is not constant. Fourth one, the relation between V by I graph is straight in line. Straight line. The graph is, relation of graph is curved line. So these are the differences in between ohmic conductors and non-ohmic conductors. Very important for it is 2 marks or 4 marks what we are doing. What are the differences between ohmic and non-ohmic conductors? Ohmic conductor means which are obey the conductors which are obey the Ohm's law. They are called ohmic conductors. The conductors which does not obey the Ohm's law, they are called non-ohmic conductors. Example, metals are, metals is the example here, non-metals and semi-metals. Third point, ohmic conductors, it will show the V by I values is constant. And here V by I is not constant. The relation between voltage and current, it will show the graph line is straight. The V by I value, the graph which shows the curved line. So this is ohmic and non-ohmic conductors. And so here voltage V, current I, resistance R. What are the relation between these two, voltage, current and resistance? According to Ohm's law, voltage is directly proportional to current. Voltage is directly proportional to current and inversely proportional to resistance. Voltage is inversely proportional to resistance. Means when voltage increases, current also increases. Voltage is inversely proportional to the resistance. When voltage increases, resistance will be decreased both. This both are, if it is increased, it is increased. If it is decreased, it is decreased. But R is inversely proportional to the current as well as voltage also. When temperature is constant, voltage is directly proportional to the current and inversely proportional to the resistance. So means if these two increases, then R will be decreased. If it is these two decreases, R will be increased. That is the main relation between the voltage, current and resistance. According to this, if you want to find the any formula, for example, if you want to find the voltage value, if you want to find the current value, if you want to find the resistance value. So for that formulas required. So if you know this triangle, let me see one of the triangle that is called massive triangle. According to basic triangle, see children, we have to easily remember the formulas. See children, here voltage, current, resistance. These are the three. It is the basic triangle. For example, if you want to know the, if you want to find the voltage, then close the voltage with your hand. Now, what is the formula, voltage formula? I into R. Then V equals to formula I into R. Then if you want to find the current, I, close the I, current means V by R. Current formula I equals to V by R. If you want to find the resistance, close the R. R equals to V by I. These are the three formulas to find the voltage, to find the current, to find the resistance. If you find the voltage, then the units are, answer units are, we have to measure with the volts. If you find the current, it is measured in amperes. Amperes. If you find the resistance, The values are in ohms. So this is the magic triangle and their values. That means here their formulas V equals to I into R. Current equals to V by R. That means I equals to V by R. Resistance R equals to V by I. So this is the magic triangle, children, and keep it in mind. This formula is very, very important, and keep it in mind the magic triangle. Whatever we completed, that is very most important. Just to re-prepare that. Okay, thank you, children. Thank you very much.